And the Traveling Cheesehead, we explore Yellowstone National Park, the entire Northern Loop, including Mammoth Hot Springs, Norris Geyser Basin, the Grand Canyon of Yellowstone, before ending our day in Hayden Valley.
Where are we going next? Let's go.
Well, good morning from Yellowstone. We're in Gardiner, Montana this morning. We got real late last night. We went to Mount Rushmore yesterday, had a great time again, and then headed over to Devil's Tower. But we spent a little extra time at Mount Rushmore, and then it's about a 2.5 hour drive over to Devil's Tower. And then from there, it's about 6.5 hours to Gardiner, which in my plans would have been perfect. However, because we spent so much time at Mount Rushmore, and then we spent a little time at Devil's Tower too, obviously, driving all the way there to see it. We didn't actually leave the Devil's Tower area till close to 4:30, 5 o'clock. So we didn't reach Gardiner until 11:30 last night, and we were so exhausted because, you know, night driving is rough, especially in this area, because of the wildlife, especially after you get off of 90 and head south towards Gardiner. It's just a lot of open road with not a lot of people and lots of animals. So we saw, what did we come across yesterday, last night? We saw a whole family of raccoons cross the street. And then I almost hit an owl. An owl just chilling in the middle of the road. But I missed him, so that was good. But you know, the fear is obviously the bigger animals. The smaller ones you can usually avoid, but the bigger ones are difficult. So we are not doing any more night driving. We obviously, by the time we got checked into our hotel here and got everything settled and cleaned up and, you know, went to sleep, it was like close to 2 o'clock in the morning. So we slept a little bit today. I got up about 8:30, my husband got up about 9:00, and we're just finishing up getting ready. We're gonna head out and have some breakfast in Gardiner here before we head into the park for the day. It's a little later than I wanted to go, but after yesterday and how late we got in, like, there was no way I was getting up that early today. But we are at the Travel Lodge by Wyndham Gardiner, and it's very cute. It's, I'll show you the outside of it later, but it's like a log cabin look. And we're on the second floor, and I'll just kind of show you the room really quick, so you can see it. It's small and quaint. So literally, here is the door and the window, and then here is our bed, and then there's, you know, cabinet and stuff like that. TV is up on the wall, and then there is a full-size refrigerator. Well, not full-size. There is a refrigerator and freezer though, which is nice to have a separate freezer to like store your ice and stuff like that. So yeah, that's our room. We kind of made a mess of it, and the bathroom's back in that corner as well. But I want to show you too our little view from outside here. How close this is to the park. If you've heard of the Roosevelt Gate, it's literally right there. So this is a great spot for northern entry into Yellowstone. I'll give you some feedback on how the lines are and everything like that as we're trying to enter the park later. And we'll talk about our breakfast and where we eat and everything as well. But so far, this is the thing. You can see it's like a little lodge. It's really cute. It's 3 floors. Parking is a little bit of an issue because we are in peak season and everything's selling out. So we ended up parking along the road last night, and I just got up this morning and moved the car. But this is the Travel Lodge, and there is the entrance to Yellowstone. So the plan today is driving to the park. We're gonna hopefully do most of the northern loop today. And then we'll probably head over to the Grand Canyon of Yellowstone, see that area before heading back for the evening. Tonight we're hoping to explore Gardiner a little bit, walk around, because we're, like I said, we're not doing night driving. So we plan on getting back here like right at dark, so, you know, 8:30, 9 or so. And then we just wanna walk around the town, see what there is to eat, maybe stuff like that, and then get really good rest. All right, so I'll catch up with you throughout the day as we see all the great stuff in Yellowstone National Park.
Just a short walk from our hotel, we found Tumbleweed Bookstore and Cafe for a delicious, healthy breakfast for under $10 for the both of us. We enjoyed huge bagel sandwiches as well as coffee. Perfect way to start our day. One of the first major stops you will come to on your visit to Yellowstone is Mammoth Hot Springs. It is a little bit more of a town as there is accommodations, restaurants, as well as a ranger station, but the main attraction are the hot springs themselves, with miles of trails for you to explore. Cleopatra Terrace. Correction, this is Mound Terrace. I said that. The sign. And I'm trying to record and watch where I'm going at the same time so I don't trip like I just did. But yeah, it is hot. There's not a lot of shady spots, lots of stairs, lots of hills, so just be prepared for that. Give you an idea, here's the trail. You can see it down there. And I was way up there. There are stairs and stuff that go around, but it is steep. This hill, I would recommend when you get here, follow the stairs up and do the paved path down. It's a little easier that way. There is more than one stop at Mammoth Hot Springs, the upper and the lower. Make sure you check out both because the scenery is incredible in both. All right. right, so we are at Norris Geyser Basin, and we're doing the shorter of the two loops right now. We'll see how we feel after this one, if we want to do the longer of the two loops, where the more geysers are. But this is it right here. It looks like it's another planet, almost like a moon surface with all these spewing hot pools everywhere. So it'll be cool if we see any eruptions. I'll try to capture them if I can, but we're gonna go hiking.
The walk is rather easy. It's an entire loop that is fairly flat. Keep in mind, this is active. You can feel the heat and smell the sulfur as you wander around the entire basin. As you make your way across Canyon Road, you will come upon Canyon Village, which again has a ranger station, a convenience store, as well as some restaurants and accommodations. It's a great stop in the middle of your day to grab a lunch before you head out and explore the Grand Canyon of Yellowstone. Upper Falls is certainly worth a stop. There are trails that unfortunately were closed during the time that we were there, but you can get really close to the waterfall when those trails are open.
Behind me there, but it's a little bit of a rat race over here to get pictures, and then we're gonna go to the top now and see even a different vantage point. It will probably be a little dogfight up there to get pictures too, but it's a beautiful spot, great kind of end of the day thing to do. The colors are beautiful and you should see the waterfall's beautiful.
Artist Point is one of the most iconic spots in the park. It is a must see on any trip.
This is the view from the top. This is the true Artist Point.
While buffalo are a common sighting in Yellowstone, it's important to remember they are wild animals and very unpredictable. It is not wise to be standing outside your car just to get a photo. They could turn on you at any moment.
Okay.
Did you see him?
Bush.
Almost got away. Bears are also common in Yellowstone, but in all my years, this is the first one I have seen this close. We'll be right back.
Gardiner is a very walkable town with a beautiful scenery surrounding it. You do have to be aware of the wild elk that wander through the town. Yellowstone pizza was a perfect way to end our night. Next time on the Traveling Cheesehead, we visit Grand Prismatic Spring, Old Faithful, and we even sneak down to Grand Teton National Park before ending our night with a local favorite.
Where are we going next? Let's go.